Hi, good afternoon. This is Jatinder Chaudhary, registered migration agent at Expert Education and Visa Services Adelaide. So today, this video is going to be about the updates which are very fresh and recent from Immigration SA about the South Australian nomination. So Immigration SA today, after a long wait, has come out with the nomination criteria for their skilled visas. They have disclosed the occupation list as well. Most of the occupation are there, which is a good news. And this time, unlike the last time, they have come up with a very detailed criteria. Obviously there will be some confusions, but I think it is pretty clear cut this time. So a lot of viewers will be interested to know as to what has changed and how they will be able to qualify. As a whole, my personal belief is they have made it very easy for a lot of people who are working in their field, and even for those who are not working in their field but they are working in some other occupation in South Australia or out region if they are South Australian graduates. So let's discuss. It will not be a very detailed discussion, but it will be a quick update as to what on the whole has changed. So this time, South Australia has come up with three priority streams. So people can apply, applicants can apply through international graduate stream, which means if they have studied a 46 weeks course in South Australia and spend 1 year of study here, they become South Australian graduate. So they will be given preference over the people who are not South Australian graduates. It was the case in the past as well, so it remains the same. The second stream is currently working in South Australia, which means if they have been working in SA for 12 months, in some cases even 6 months. The third stream would be Talent and Innovator Program, which is the new stream basically. This stream was not there previously. Obviously, part of it was there, like high GPA pathways and all. But as a whole, it seems to be a new stream. So let's start with International Graduate of SA stream. So basically, for International Graduates of SA, for most of the occupations, for 491 visa, you need 3 months of experience. But for some occupations, they can ask for more experience. And for 190 visa, generally 12 months of experience in your field. But for some occupations, they can be waivers and they might ask for more occupations. For example, for accounting, they are still asking more experience, but waivers are still there. We'll discuss the waivers later. So basically 12 months for 190, 491, 3 months. And there's another change which is quite big. They are saying the experience is in your field as long as it is within the two-digit level. For example, for engineering experience, all the occupations which are assessed by engineers, they are considered to be relevant. So for example, if you are a civil engineer but you are working as some other engineer, your experience will still be considered as relevant, which is a very good news. Now, waivers for international graduates, they are quite good waivers, very good looking one. For example, high GPA. If you have 6 GPA and above, IT and engineering, you look pretty good for 190 or 491 visa. So your experience requirement can be waived completely. And occupation wise, very good news. They have clearly mentioned this time, although it used to work before as well, but this time they've clearly mentioned, if you are an RN or EN, but you're working as an aged care worker or disability support worker, your experience will be counted as relevant. So even if you are working less hours for 491 visa, they are considering that as well. For example, if you're applying for a 491 visa, but your work hours haven't been 20 hours per week, you have only been working 10 hours per week, you can access a waiver and you can apply for 491 visa for South Australian graduates, which is really good news. And long-term resident, those who are SA graduates, plus they are long-term residents as well, then they need 12 months of experience in any occupation, any work. It can even be non-skilled work. So, which is a very, very good way. I think a lot of people will be able to access that waiver if they are not working in the skilled occupations, but they are long-term resident and they are SA graduates as well. Now, this was about international graduates, so it looks pretty good. I can't go in too much details because the video has to be short and sweet. But we can discuss further in detail if you book a personal appointment with me or with Expert Education and Visa Services. Now, second stream, apart from SA graduate, people who are not SA graduate but they are currently working in SA. They can be interstate graduates or overseas graduates, but they are currently working. So their nomination will obviously depend upon which occupation they are in, plus other things, how long you have been living in SA and how long you have been working in South Australia. Or if you are working in outer region, which is outside Greater Adelaide. So all these three things will decide which visa you will get and will you be eligible or not. So for 491 visa for non-SA graduates, generally 6 months required, but it will vary from occupation to occupation. Generally 6 months for most occupations, and for 190, 12 months generally for most occupations. Outer region waiver. So if you are not SA graduate, but you are living and working in outer region of SA for 12 months, you can apply 491 visa, even if your work experience is not skilled. It can be any work experience, but it should be continuous for 12 months. So that's for currently working in SA criteria. Now, currently working in SA can also access few more waivers of work if they have also been living in SA for long term. One, it has two streams basically. One stream is if you are living in SA for 3 years, you can apply 491. And if you're living in SA for 5 years, you can apply 190. But the work experience has to be from level 1 to level 4 skilled occupation. Even carers are included in that. But somebody who's working, for example, as a kitchen hand, that's a level 8 experience, so that may not be considered. But if they're working as a chef, they are not SA graduates, but they have been living in South Australia for more than 3 years, they can apply 491. Second stream, people who have been living in SA for more than 7 years, for them 12 months of experience, even if it's non-skilled, all good. But for that 7 year pathway, they are not including people who are on a student visa or a graduate visa holder. So those applicants are excluded. So this was about the currently working in SA criteria. Now third stream basically, which is a new stream, Talent and Innovators Program. Talent and Innovator Program is a new program. It has four streams. One of the stream is old one, which is high performing graduate of SA, basically PhD graduates or master by research graduate or high GPA in master and bachelor as well. There's a big change in this one this time. Previously, high GPA just in master was not considered if they did not have a bachelor from SA. Now it has changed. Even if somebody has done only a master's here and they have high GPA more than 6, depending upon other, if they meet other criterias, they might be eligible. So that's about one stream of Talent and Innovator other than high GPA and high performing graduate. They have employment stream. They need 12 months of experience, and their employer need to have certain threshold of their turnover, yearly turnover. If they meet that, they can apply under the employment stream of Talent and Innovator program. Then there's a startup and small business stream, which is going to be extremely, extremely good for some of the people who have come here. They don't qualify for, if they don't qualify for other streams, like SA graduate pathway or currently working in pathway, if they are self-employed, they can use this stream. For example, if somebody has a skill assessment, but they are not working in that field, they are not employed through an employer, but they have their own business. There are some requirements that business need to meet, but if they meet that business requirement, one of the requirement is it cannot be a franchise business. So there are other as well. One of the requirement is this, and they have this, have the, they have been running this business for more than 12 months and residing in SA for more than 24 months. They can use that stream as well, which is extremely good as well. Another one, independent talent. If somebody has considerable skills and overseas experience in their skill, and it is related to growth sector industry, which includes health sector, research, and all some other sectors as well, engineering, for example. If they have considerable skills in that field, they can get waiver of experience as well. So that's about Talent and Innovator. I quickly touched it, but we can discuss in detail case to case basis. So these are the three streams. Lastly, I just want to quickly touch base a few of the occupations very quickly. For example, because they have changed considerably in some occupations. For example, enroll nurse, the biggest change in that is they can even apply for 190 visa, which was not the case previously, last few years at least. They can even apply 190 visa as long as they are working in outer region for 12 months. So somebody who has been working for 12 months in countryside, outer region of SA, they can apply for even 190 visa. Obviously, 3 months and applying 491 still exists. And so 6 months, if they're applying as an SA graduate, only 3 months experience required as EN. But if they're not SA graduate, they can even apply with 12 month experience in Adelaide or 6 months in countryside for non-SA graduates. So that's about it. And one of the biggest thing, I think I previously touched base as well, if they're working as a care worker, they can still apply. That's about enroll nurses. I can't discuss all the occupations, but I'm just giving you a heads up as to some of the occupations, how they have changed. So most of the occupations might have a new criteria. So I touched base account enroll nurse. Now I'm going to quickly touch base accountants. For accountants, obviously SA graduate pathway is there, but currently working in SA pathway is also there. Those who are not SA graduate, they can go through currently working in SA pathways. They need 24 months experience for 190, 2 years basically, and 12 months for 491. So which, but they've clearly said for accountants, they cannot guarantee the nomination. Hopefully they will nominate everybody, but it looks like at least we can, to start with, the occupation is open. And they have also said for SA graduate, if they have high GPA, they can even access the waiver of work experience. But they need proficient plus English, which is 7.5 in each in IELTS. So for accountants, good news is the occupation is open and we can apply. Obviously, experience requirements are a bit higher, but it's still open. So for most engineers and IT graduates, I'm just saying most, but it may not be applicable to all IT or engineering, but I'm saying most of those, if they have 18 months experience, 190 in outer region, and 12 months in outer region and 18 months in Adelaide, and for 491, 6 months experience, most of them, some of them you can even apply with less. But for SA graduate, if they have proficient English, they can apply 190 with 12 month experience. And if they have proficient English and they have high GPA as well, they might be given a waiver of work experience as well. So that's about most engineers. And if they have only 5 GPA and above, and they have competent plus English, they can apply 491 with waiver of work experience. But all these work experience not eligible, not applicable to all the occupations. So we'll have to discuss about your particular occupation if we need to. So guys, I've taken a lot of time. I did not mean to have such a long video, but I think there was a lot of content. I've tried to just touch base the important points. Obviously, if you have further questions and you want to check your accessibility, you can contact Expert Education and Visa Services Adelaide. Thank you. Bye.